for our next bout of the evening will be for the minus 67 kilogram Muay Thai Grand Prix world title. And so please welcome to the blue corner from Sheffield, it's Tommi McCormick!
Well, certainly one of the most anticipated contests of the night so far, and one that the audience here at the O2, and I'm sure many of you at home, have been looking forward to as well. The first man on his way to the ring, Tommi McCormick, well over 20 years in the game, experience, technical and elusive, based in Sheffield out of Body Flow Gym. And Dave, interestingly, on the poll on the Muay Thai Grand Prix website this morning, 64% of fans believe that he will come out the victor tonight. How much can we read into that?
I have to say, I do think this fight is all about styles, and styles make fights. And Tommi McCormick, it depends which Tommi McCormick turns up. He's a very talented guy, very awkward movement.
Tommi,
I've seen him steamroller
people.
I've also seen him stand off and pick people off. I just think it's going to be a very tough test for Charlie Peters.
And please welcome to the red corner from Bexley in Kent, it's Kent's favourite fighting son, it's Charlie Boy Peters!
Well, fresh off the back of one world title shot, straight into another for Charlie Peters. What a year he had last year, victorious in that grueling four-man tournament at the second Muay Thai Grand Prix in November, setting himself up for a world title shot against Fabio Pinker over in the United States. He had a terrific first round, but then, unfortunately for him, whether it was a combination of him not turning up and Fabio Pinker being as good as he is, he was in for a really grueling following four rounds. However, Dave, you would say he would come back richer for the experience and better for it over the last 3 or 4 months as well, and he would have learned a lot about himself.
Yeah, I mean, Charlie's a true professional, absolute gentleman outside the ring, a true technician inside the ring. He's been out and he's fought some of the best in the world. He's only going to benefit from that. It's not going to do him any harm, put it that way. It was a great experience. You saw how he performed in this four-man tournament before.
Charlie,
the guy is a talent. This is going to be an awesome battle. McCormick's got a very good range on him. Very tall opponent.
So, ladies and gentlemen, this full tie rules bout will be contested for the minus 67 kilogram Muay Thai Grand Prix world title. This bout will be contested over 5 3-minute rounds. Introducing to you, firstly, fighting out of the blue corner, representing Body Flow Gym in Sheffield. He brings a record of 37 wins with 6 defeats. Please welcome Turbo Tommi McCormick! And across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, a young man who needs no introduction in the south of England and around the world. He brings a record of 32 wins with 8 losses and 1 draw, representing Double K Gym in Bexley, Kent. It's Charlie Boy Peters!
Gentlemen, come to the centre.
Well, no guessing who the fan favourite and one who would be considered the hometown fighter tonight, Charlie Boy Peters, in the red corner as they are brought to the centre for their instructions. And as you mentioned, Dave, already you can just see there the significant height disadvantages that Peters faces.
Your referee in charge of the action, Mr. Sean Boland.
McCormick. I wonder how that will manifest itself over the next 5 rounds. Big night for Charlie Peters, missing out on that world title over in the States. Can he capture one on home turf? Surely that would be huge compensation. A disappointing start to the year from him. So 5 3-minute rounds here at the O2 Arena in London.
Just watch McCormick's movement. That's one thing I love watching when he fights. He's very unpredictable. This is where they test each other. McCormick's been fighting since he was a kid. I don't know how old he was. I saw a picture of him fighting when he looked to be about 6 or 8 years old or something like that.
Wow.
But he's been in the sport a number of years.
He looks very calm and focused, does McCormick.
Change his stance with ease there. Be interesting to see how he throws off each side.
It's been a controlled and static pace in these early moments of the fight. And an important occasion for both men and one not to be rushed.
That's it. This is the important phase where they sense each other out, look for the opportunities.
McCormick has slammed that body kick in twice now, the last 15 seconds. Peters returns.
You can hear Kieran Kettle shouting there to Charlie Boy Peters. He can't block those kicks. You saw McCormick just blocking the kick on his arms there slightly. I wonder if that's something that he favours doing to set up some fighters. You see them do that. They get scored on to throw a shot of their own, but not always a good plan to be scored on like that.
Just see Peters just throwing those little feints, seeing if he's going to trigger a response, draw a lead from McCormick. But interesting data gathering exercise this from both men. Both have thrown a little bit in way of kicks, but haven't let the hands go too much yet.
They're starting to go a bit harder here. As soon as they see openings, they'll start planting the shots in. Love watching Muay Thai at this level. Full Muay Thai rules, A-class bout. Knees and elbows are low to the head.
McCormick using the full width of the ring. Just again switching from orthodox, southpaw, and then back again, and he puts Peters down.
Box.
Sweeping the leg.
That's it, missed it first time. Charlie managed to stand up to it, so he made sure he did it the second.
30 seconds to go in a chess match of a first round for this world title.
Truly is a joy to watch at this level. You know the power that's going to come from these guys. Just a little bit off balance there, Tommy, when he threw that.
Come on, box.
He just wets his feet in the corner, so he gets a bit better grip.
Fine. Nice body kick. In.
Yeah.
Good way to finish.
You hear the power in these guys. Little Andy Housen in the corner there.
So an interesting first round. Will be intriguing to see what both corners have made of their opposition and the men in front of them. Kieran Kettle there.
Yeah, he's called Andy in the corner there. Andy's got a wealth of experience in this sport. Multiple world champion. Fought for many, many years. I think he's about 46 now. Been given some good advice there to Charlie Peters. Look how composed he looks in the corner.
Seconds out.
Corners, 10 seconds.
Boston's ready.
A bit of reddening on the front legs of both men.
Yeah, the thing is that this weight, when they hit hard.
Red corner. Round two, box.
So away we go, round two of five. World title on the line.
Lovely block there from Peters. Landed a nice left hook before it too. He was told to step in a bit more on his kicks, which he just did.
Nice push kick there from Peters, just moves out of the way of the high kick from McCormick and then delivers one to the thigh in response. Good start from the man in red, and another kick to the midsection.
Yeah, Charlie's stepping in on his shots a bit better now and landing those body kicks nicely.
It's Peters, he's holding the center at present. Conundrum of McCormick as he switches stances again, just delivers both legs with seemingly parallel ease.
You see McCormick's unorthodox style there as he moves around a little bit, his hands change.
A wry smile from Peters there. That shot didn't miss by much.
Yeah, it was like an acknowledgement. That almost hit your head. This is where you see McCormick change a little bit. See his movement and his style. I think it makes him very awkward to pin down, but Peter's doing a good job of doing it.
Oh, wow, great timing. Right. And Peter smiles in acknowledgement as he was put down there. The leg caught.
Again, it's not a real big influencer in this fight, and Charlie's doing the better work and landing the better shots.
Nice, real force behind that body kick with the rear leg from Peters. Sharp hook to the body from McCormick, though.
That's it. Landed on the ribs of Charlie Peters, but he took it well.
It's good work from Peters. Good footwork, too, keeping out of range. Low kick from McCormick, trying to draw the attention of Peters.
Attempt at an elbow there, it looked like, from McCormick from the left.
Good footwork in the clinch from McCormick. He's just driven. Peters backed onto the ropes just above our commentary position here at the Indigo 02.
Both guys have supreme balance in the clinch there. Good control, centering their gravity there.
Oh, McCormick came in looking to land a long left. He walked into a short hook.
Charlie now stalking his man and catching him in the corner a bit more.
That's the first sense of urgency from McCormick, which you haven't seen so far. Nice knees from him in the clinch.
Good little turn there from Peters. Box. I think Peters will be growing in confidence as this goes on. Cheeky little elbow over the top from Peters, but you can hear Kieran Kettle in the corner there saying, no elbows for the moment, please. Only knees. Looking to get big scores in. Again, that's the sort of level of tuition in the corner there. Kieran Kettle's been there and done that himself.
Took over the top of it and delivers a body kick. McCormick responds with one of his own. Whoa. Well, McCormick banged the kick in, but Peters showing dominance, standing over him. Bit of go, bit of showmanship that. There.
And the body language, it's all just to say, I've got you here. It's round three, they call it the money round.
And things start to hot up a little bit. Nice work from Peters again, and then quick feet to get himself out of trouble.
This is a good Charlie Peters we're seeing today, blocking nicely.
Well, we asked the question before, would he have learnt from his experiences in the last 4.5, 5 months, and well, so far so good from the man in the red.
Keep the kicks up.
Little accidental groin shot there, again good sportsmanship from both lads. These guys are the elite at this level, from the Muay Thai Grand Prix. Fighting for the world title. A massive kick there from Peters landing.
When you are so close, you really do feel as well as hear the force of that impact. Oh, goodness me, and it's the second one that's been driven in to the inside of the groin there. And, well, I don't think there's any particular intent there from McCormick. He did apologise the first time, but it's just a painful area to take a shot.
It's McCormick's style where he changes and switches stance and stuff. It's easy to do that by accident, I think. There's no way he's doing it on purpose. Lovely timed left body kick there from Peters. Box. Just tucking that kick under the arm like that. Good scoring technique.
McCormick McCormick just gathering a little bit of momentum as this round has progressed. About a minute 10 to go in round three. Peter's cutting off the ring, making it hard for McCormick, not giving him a great deal of space. He's only got the ropes directly behind him now. Peter's open up, looking for a gap hit. Just misses with that high kick. The referee has to jump in.
Okay, guys, box.
And save him. Nice hands from McCormick, good timing on the right. Oh, and again, the timing is the round's progressing, just box. Catching that rear leg with increased frequency, and the sweep comes off the back of it.
That double kick that McCormick does is dangerous too. If you go down and you get hit with that second one, often that can land clean. See that a lot in Thailand. They kick them and try and kick them in the head on the, as they're just hitting the floor too. Perfectly legal if it's timed right. Again, nice turn there from Peters. Showing his dominance in the clinch, Charlie Peters tonight.
Stop boxing, break, step back. Box. Time.
Good round there for Peters, I'd say. I'd say he's starting to step away with this fight. Again, we're early days.
At the end of round four.
Round three of the fight. Now, Andrew Tate, you join us again. Of course, it's a world title fight. What does that mean? You can hear it's so quiet out there. What's it mean for the fighters?
Yeah, I think a world title is obviously the pinnacle of where everyone wants to get to. When everyone starts off with kickboxing, they imagine world titles. So a little bit of extra pressure when there's a world title on the line. I've fought for four of them myself. I know how it feels to win.
Four and one.
Yeah, I fought four and one. So I know exactly how important it is to the fighters. So it's a lot of extra pressure. There's no music on. That might have just been personal preference from the fighters. Sometimes they decide not to have it. It's very traditional in Thailand. But here in the West, it's something they can opt in and out of. So perhaps it's something suddenly.
Rounds four and five, predominantly known as the money rounds. Things are going to hot now, Miriam.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, these are both very experienced guys. They're both taking their time. They're being very clean and clever with their techniques. But like you said, the last two rounds are where you really want to catch the judges' scorecards. So,
guys, I'm backing a boy from Bexley. Come on, Charlie.
Yeah. Okay, well, hand back to the fight. Thank you, Andrew.
Andrew Tate there, four-time K1 world champion. Man of great experience himself. He's watching on intently, knows Charlie Peters well. Peters just missing with that high kick again.
You see Tommy McCormick coming forward a bit more in this round.
Box.
Charlie switching and taking the centre of the ring as he eats a solid body kick there from Tommy McCormick.
Stop boxing, break, break. Let go, step back. Box.
I love the psychology going on between these boys during this fight as that head kick lands finally.
Just crashed on the side of the jaw of McCormick. He took it really well.
That's it. It was just the foot of Peters, not the shin. Had it been the shin, it might have been a different story.
McCormick again moving around, resetting. Looking for the teep.
Yeah, he does that really well. Just moves off, continually moving. He's not a sitting duck. But he seems to be a bit about single shots there at the moment. And Peter's just doing the better work for me.
Again, Peter's just trying to cut the ring off. McCormick comes in and caught the front leg, not able to capitalise. Just missed again.
Box.
Flying high kick.
Sean Boland, referee there. Experienced referee, just straight in between the fighters there for fighter safety. As Peters goes crashing to the canvas.
Just glancing kick, body kick there from Peters.
McCormick switches up his style between moving around a lot and then suddenly he just stands there in front of you and starts trying to hit you.
Jumping.
Peter's just saying, where are you going, mate? Bit of banter going on.
Some good, sharp exchanges between these two. Good work.
Lovely vision there. Lovely vision by Peters.
And in came the elbow as McCormick was off balance on the ropes.
That's it. He saw exactly where McCormick was going. Took the leg. as he lands a heavy shot again.
McCormick, I think, got a shot in of his own, but Peters was last in the exchange, and that maybe will leave the impression on the judges. 25 seconds to go in a crucial round four. Peters just missing with the lead left. No kick, and again, that sign of frustration perhaps from Peters that he was caught there.
I don't know, it might be a sign of frustration or of being caught, or I think it might be a little bit of mind games to say, what was that, mate? You're not hurting me. And he's coming forward. You can see the eyes on both of them there. Look as they just come apart. Charlie Peters is supremely confident, acknowledging the crowd, and Tommy McCormick, as soon as they caught eyes, walked away with his head down, looking to the canvas.
That's right, boys.
There's a lot to be said for how people act in the corner. And well, I think this fight is going in the way of Charlie Peters more and more.
Well, let's take a look. See there, Charlie Peters surrounded by his cohort, Kieran Kettle and the like. They'll be reading their man his final instructions on what they hope will be his night for the world title. If we look at some of the highlights here, McCormick on the ropes, and that was the sweep from Peters, and then as he was off balance, bang, the elbow in behind it, and well, that really will leave a lasting impression. And then the elbow on top of the head too.
Yeah, that first one was really well timed, kicking the leg out, and as they go down, striking,
corners,
big score, very effective.
Boxers ready.
Some really good quality work there, left hook that landed flush on McCormick.
And again, body language crucial as we see Peters first to the centre. He wants to go.
Step back.
And all of these little tricks and tips just sticking in the mind of the judges. Crucial fifth round, world title fight. Charlie Peters, Tommy McCormick. Away we go. McCormick just misses the sweep.
I feel that McCormick needs a knockout to win this. And I think this is Charlie Peters' fight. If he can just score smartly, I think we might see McCormick try and do something. Nice, nice work there from Peters. All he needs to do is jab, kick, keep the points up, keep safe. Very well fought today by Charlie Peters, but do not rule out Tommy McCormick.
No, walked McCormick into a straight right hand net. Bang on the button.
Charlie took the back nicely as well, and a great low kick there, well timed to take his man down.
Fantastic stuff from Peters, and now just applying some extra pressure. McCormick backs against the ropes, high kick, just partially blocked. Oh, nice short elbow on the inside of the clinch.
Stop boxing,
from Peters.
Right. Step back.
Yeah, and then nice solid stance there. Peters just looking up and acknowledging the time. He knows exactly what he's doing in there, very composed. Been there time and time again.
He's drawn the first bit of blood from the face of McCormick, pouring from the nose now.
Yeah, he's popped the nose there. A good shot down the middle. And again it lands.
McCormick having to will himself forward, really. Swings and misses. And a jumping elbow from him. And again, the face test, really, being won currently by Charlie Peters, and everything about his body language suggests that he's the boss in there, holding the centre, pushing McCormick back, blocking that body kick.
McCormick's got a minute to do something special, otherwise I feel this is Charlie Peters' fight all day long. A convincing and solid win against a formidable opponent. And
as we mentioned earlier, the polls were well in favour of McCormick through midday today.
Charlie Peters will be very happy with this result then. As long as nothing out of the ordinary happens in the next 30 seconds.
His corner screaming at Charlie Peters now. Lovely head movement. McCormick just trying, throwing a couple of last ditch game changing shots perhaps. Nothing landing so far. Oh. 20 seconds on the clock.
Charlie, I don't know if you heard that. As Charlie McCormick evaded the kick and took a body kick from McCormick while he was over the ropes, he then turned to the crowd and said, I'll let him have that. So that shows you how relaxed Charlie Peters is in this final round.
Lovely finish.
Of his world title fight.
Lovely finish from Peters. And well, as we said, has that experience over in the United States at the top, top level, just giving him what he needed to perform the way he has performed tonight. Could he have performed in that relaxed manner had he not had that experience in January? Who knows, but one thing's for sure, he's given a great account of himself tonight, and if he does get the decision, he is a worthy winner, and he looks confident.
This is, I think Charlie knows it's his all day long, and I think it shows what a professional he is. He's come back off a loss against a formidable opponent, but he's come back and fought a hard fight against another tough guy, and he's come out and he's brought the business. He's done it, he's taken that belt. Fair play, Charlie Peters.
We'll go to the judges' scorecards. Still lots of action to look forward to coming up. Victor Saravia and Dan McGowan, who performed so well the last time around.
Yeah, that's got the making of a massive fight. Victor making waves in the USA.
The rounds of action.
Well done, boys.
And after those five rounds of action, your ringside judges have reached a unanimous decision, all in favour of your winner. And the new minus 67 kilogram MTGP world champion fighting out of the red corner, it's Charlie Boy Peters. And show your appreciation for our runner-up, Tommi McCormick.
Well, never an easy route to a world title, but Charlie Peters adds the title of world champion to his resume here at the Muay Thai Grand Prix. Fantastic night for him. There, picture with his team, and that must mean an awful lot to the young man. He's had a tough 6 months.
Yeah, he has, but I mean, that's the making, that's what champions are made of, and he's just shown
Charlie,
how good he is.
Charlie! Here we go again. Muay Thai Grand Prix. World champion, come on. Tough cookie, that lad. You know about him before, don't you?
I've known about him for a long time, and I've watched him fight so many times. He's entertaining, he's tricky. He's great to watch, he's a nightmare to fight.
You hit him with a couple of elbows in that fight, and his head didn't even move. How does that make you feel when you let them off?
Weak. He's hard, man, he's hard. He's used to taking elbows. I just didn't throw it hard enough.
Nice, intelligent fight from you tonight, Charlie. Anyone you think that you're going to defend that belt against coming up?
To be honest, I'd like to fight someone foreign for it, being a world title. So, in all honesty, I haven't had time to think. You did tell me to think, but I haven't. So I don't mind. I don't mind.
Plenty of time to think. I'm sure your coach is going to get someone lined up for you, Charlie. One more time, ladies and gentlemen. Muay Thai Grand Prix world champion, Charlie Boy Peters. Come on.
Charlie Peters is taking home the world title fight. That was a fantastic fight, wasn't it, Dan?
Good day, KB, wasn't it? The boy from Bexley got the job done. Come on!
Look at how happy he is. The boy from Bexley has just got his world title. We will be talking to him in a second. But
ladies and gentlemen, your information jerkies are now...
wasn't the result you wanted, but it was still a great fight.
Price, so.
Not to me. It was a rubbish fight for me. I was just waiting too long. I saw openings and I was just thinking too much, didn't really let anything go, so I lost it myself really. It wasn't like Charlie just fought his fight, like I knew how he was going to fight, prepared for that, I just went flowing, like, so I'm gutted that it was my fight to lose rather than for Charlie to win, so, but fair play to Charlie, he did exactly what he needed to do, nullified a few things that I was trying to work on, I think he just got mad a little bit and Yeah, come on top, fair enough. Got no arguments with the result. He's a good lad. Hopefully I'll get another chance. Yeah.
And is rematch going through your head? Is that what you want next? What's next for you?
There's no plans really. I work full time as an engineer, so I don't really have to fight as a, you know, I just do it as a hobby really. So I just take fights as if they interest me, then I'll fight. But yeah, I'd love to fight Charlie again, without a doubt.
Someone told you before the fight, you're not easy to hit. They're not wrong, are they?
No, yeah, but I'm very elusive, but sometimes, yeah, I think it counts against me when I don't counter. And a lot of times I was making a miss, but I went countering. So that, it just, I was thinking too much about everything I was throwing in. Should have just let it go. One of them things I'm going to... punch myself about it if, probably a few months in the gym, but you learn from it and you get back in, and yeah, hopefully I'll get another chance at Charlie. Maybe drop down a few fighters in the rankings, build a bit of confidence back up, and yeah, give Charlie another go.
It's a tough fight, mate. You've done well. Well done.
Thanks for talking to us. That was Tommi McCormick.
Get a champion.
The world champion here, Charlie Peters. Congratulations.
Thank you. I don't know, yeah.
Thanks. So your coach, you're only one world title behind him now, Amir and Kieran.
Yeah, I think so, actually, yeah. Yeah, he's got three. I've actually got three.
Oh, you got three now?
Yeah, so I'm on level, but he's got the more prestigious, I guess.
It has. You really took over the fourth and fifth round. You really took over there.
I think I had to. It was close. It was a close first, second. The third, I think I edged it. But yeah, the fourth and fifth, I had to go forward more. The thing is I know Tommy. I've known him for years. I've watched him for years. He's a great fighter. He's elusive. But he's dangerous because he throws shots from wild places. He fights Muay Thai, but not traditional Muay Thai. Traditional Muay Thai, they stand there, trade off. Tommy's elusive, moves off, throws a lot of feints and a lot of tricky shots. So I had to be careful. I did think it was going to be a boring fight, but at the same time, I didn't want to go rushing in to make it exciting and get caught myself. You know, I know I threw a few punches that were looping, you know, like haymakers, and he was moving away. But it's better than not throwing them. I didn't want to throw loads of them and make it look a sloppy fight on my part. You still have to look strong, smart, and everything else. So
I'll let you go away and celebrate. Congratulations.
Well done, mate. Well done.
Fantastic. Love the fact that they're both so humble, but we're going to hand back over to Pete, the curtain. It's fight number